Good morning, everyone. Mary Houghton here for Yoga Stretch. Always have some flows in there as well. So welcome, welcome. A couple things I'd want to cover before we get started, because I don't know if we have any new people. A few things. Hydration, hydration, hydration. Also, safety and good form walk hand in hand together. Always make sure that you're paying attention to your posture. You're lengthening through your spine, so imagine someone's pulling on your ponytail. You're lifting the heart, you're dropping the shoulders, you're cinching the waist, and you're going to squeeze the booty as often and as long as possible, always. The other thing is we're all at different levels of practice, so make sure that you are honoring your body. You know your body better than anyone. Never let your muscles scream at you. It's okay if they speak to you, but it's not okay if they scream at you. So let's have a wonderful, the other thing, please like us on Facebook, share the video, save it. Next Thursday, so I believe that is the 6th, next Tuesday, which will be the 3rd. Next Tuesday, I will not be teaching a live video, but Mary Byrne will be putting a video up at this time and as well as at noon for yoga and women on weights. So I hope you'll tune in, and I'm doing my annual trip to Vegas with Miss Karen, and so I will be back Thursday. And don't forget, Thursday our yoga class is going to start at 10:45, so we can get a little more stretching done and not be cut so short. So let's get started. I'll start the music. Please let me know if the music's too loud. I will check the comments after we stretch out. So welcome, welcome. Let's have a wonderful practice. Also, let me know if you don't hear the music as well. So let's get started. We're going to start on the floor, and then we'll work our way up to our feet and then back down again. So let's get started. So we're going to take a moment to set our intent for today's practice. So your back is in neutral position, so that natural curvature of your spine is in place. You're also going to lengthen through the spine, lift the heart, drop the shoulders back and down. Inhale through the nose, out through the mouth, big belly breaths, let that belly hang out. And just make sure that you're sitting up nice and tall. Take your hands right below your chest line, or hugging those that rib cage, and I want you to inhale nice and big. Expand those intercostal muscles, expand the rib cage. Try not to lift too much in the shoulders, so we're not doing this. We're just expanding the rib cage and hold. Big breaths and holding the breath, you're making your lungs stronger. and slow exhale. Please let me know if you hear that music. And if you don't, let me know as well. Exhale, forward fold. Tiptoe those fingertips away from your feet. Let your spine sink down in between your scaps. Maybe rock those shoulders back and forth. Maybe you'll have a nice big yawn in there somewhere. Take those hands to the right. Drop the left shoulder, sink down. Keep your jaw nice and relaxed. Back to center. Take it to the left. Reach that right hand out, drop into the shoulder. And back to center, roll it up. Take the feet nice and wide. So whenever I go into a wide position, I angle myself. So you don't have to angle yourself. So we're going to tuck the pelvis up toward the ceiling, hollow the chest, drop the chin, and then tilt the pelvis back toward the floor and reach, reach, reach. Let your belly settle down in between the thighs. Knees are nice and wide. Hands are going to float. Up and down your leg, whichever works best for you. And then exhale. Really stick that pelvis up. Resist the urge to drop up. Push the belly out. Sink the shoulders down. Inhale. Cinch the waist so your back is in a strong neutral position. We're not sitting back like this at all. So tilt that pelvis toward the floor. Inhale. Lengthen through the spine. Reach, reach, reach. Dorsiflex the feet. And when you've reached as far as you think you can go, then relax. It's not about getting your nose to your knees. It's about lengthening this lower spine. You should feel that in your calves, your hamstrings, your glutes, and of course your lower spine. Just warm it up a little bit. This is not passive, okay? So everything should be activated. Your legs are activated, your feet are dorsiflexed, perhaps your heels are coming up off the floor, you're feeling some pressure into the quads, and definitely pressure into the back, lifting through the heart. Breathe. Never hold your breath, unless I tell you to at the beginning, or unless you're underwater. So let's stack our knees. We're going to take our left knee stack it on top of the right. Make sure you're not sitting on your right foot. Now, if this is too much, you can be like this and just really push into that hip. So if stacking the knees is a little stressful, then modify accordingly. So once you stack the knees or find your modified position, go ahead and relax down. Switching. Stack those hips. Again, make sure you're not sitting on the left foot. And when you're ready, if you're ready, go ahead and sink down. And we're going to push into, especially the right knee is on top, so you can push into the right booty. Stretching those glutes. Hi, Libby. Thank you for joining me today. So, we're going to come up onto our hands and knees. Opening up the hip flexors. So, ideally, remember your wrists are directly below your shoulders. If you have tricky wrists, then you can roll them out. Your hands can be forward. You could be on your fist. So, always listen to your body, what's best for you. So what I want you to do right now is I want you to sink deep into child's pose, and you're going to stretch those hands out actively, and you're going to draw forward, drop the hips, bend into the elbows, warming up the arms, draw the belly in, take it back. Inhale, inhale, squeeze that booty, bend into the elbows, so make sure that that spine isn't sinking in, so the shoulders stay lift up, down, out of your ears, but your elbows bent. Inhale, one more. Very good. So, let's come back into box position. Curl the toes under. We're going to lift into downward dog. Strong neutral spine. You should feel this in your hamstrings, calves, and glutes. A little in the back. And then we're going to come back down, but we're going to hover. And we're going to push back up. And come back down. Inhale, keep that belly lifted. Exhale. Inhale. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, swan dive. Take it all the way down. Maybe grasp the opposing elbows. Nod yes, shake no. Soften the knees, tight the pelvis, cinch the waist, squeeze the booty, reach, reach, reach. And exhale, out, down, and away. Grab a drink. So we're warming up our core now. We're going to do a fun little sequence of chair, forward fold, that sort of thing. But I'm going to go nice and slow, so I'm not going to give you an example of the flow. We got another comment. I'm going to check on the volume of the music. Hang with me. So let's step to the front of our mat. Again, lengthen through the spine. Lift the heart, drop the shoulders back and down, cinch the waist. Inhale. Exhale, swan dive. Stick that booty out, strong neutral spine. Inhale, half lift. Now I'm going to challenge you to draw that belly button off the inside of your shirt. Strong lift, hinging at the hips. Straight back. Chair. So remember with chair, your knees stay behind the toes. Your back is in neutral position. You're not going to push that belly out. Now, if you feel your booty trying to round, you want to come up a little bit. So it's all about form and safety. It's great if you can go low, but only if you can go low safely and with that neutral spine. Inhale. Exhale, swan dive. Inhale, half lift. Hands come out, lift, hinging at the hips, keeping the back strong and straight. And into chair. Line of sight should be forward at a downward angle. You should be able to see the inside of your arms in your peripheral vision. Weight should be in your heels. You should be able to wiggle your toes. Inhale. Now we're going to go right back into chair. We're going to tap. stacked above the hips. Hands to your heart space, open to the right. So there should be a straight line from hand, shoulder, shoulder to hand. Sweep the floor with that right hand, hands to your heart space, open to the left. So this is the awkward side. I think I'm going to change this flow, but we're going slow enough, that's okay. Hands to your heart space. Since we already did a standing split, let's make it a little more interesting. Hands come down. Lift the right foot up, three-legged dog, hips open. Reach, reach, reach. Square the hips, come up tall on the toes of your left foot. Bend that right knee, draw it in, so you're going to round that spine and place that right foot forward. Try not to drag it and rise. Soft step forward. Inhale. Exhale. Right foot steps back. Crescent. Sit nice and low to your comfort level, to your strength level. Hands to your heart space. Open to the left. Keep those shoulders stacked above the hips. We're not drawing forward. Smile. Sweep. Hands to your heart space. Open to the right. This is the more awkward side. Square the hips, come up tall on the toes of your right foot, bend the left knee, draw it to your chest, place it forward, and rise into crescent. So whenever we bring that foot forward, our goal is to try not to drag the foot. Stop, step forward. One more on each side. Inhale, exhale, left foot steps back. Strong, powerful position. Check those shoulders. Hands to your heart space. Open to the right. Sweep. Hands to your heart space. Open to the left. Square the hips, come up tall on the toes of your left foot, bend the right knee, draw it to your chest, and drive forward again, trying not to drag the foot. Crescent. Soft step forward. Inhale, exhale, right foot. posture, lengthening through that spine, lifting through the heart, hands come down, left foot lifts, reach it up. You may have to pull those hands closer in to really get a nice strong stretch. Reach, reach, reach. Square the hips, come up tall on the toes of your left foot, bend the left knee. Come up on the toes of your right foot. Bend the knee, draw it into the chest, place the left foot forward, and rise into crescent. Soft step forward. Inhale, exhale, out, down, and away. Grab a drink, our next flow. We're going to be going into plank. So again, you can float your feet back. I'm not going to float because of my bones in my left foot. So if you're stepping back and stepping forward out of the plank, make sure you alternate your lead leg. We always tend to favor our strongest side. So make a conscious effort to alternate that, please. So, come to the end of your mat, front of your mat. Inhale, exhale, swan dive, lead with the chest. Oh, I forgot to do the fast version. I'll do the fast version. Swan dive, inhale, down, step, step. Downward dog. Inhale. Exhale, chaturanga into cobra. Exhale, back into downward dog. Inhale, plank. Step forward, float your feet forward. Okay, so that's the fast version. We're going to slow it way down. So, inhale. Exhale, swan dive. Lead with the chest. Inhale, half lift. Check that posture. Is your back strong in neutral position? Is your belly button off the inside of your shirt? Exhale, hands come down. Exhale, step or float your feet back into plank. Exhale, downward dog. Really sink that spine in between the scaps. Enjoy this position. Inhale, plank. Exhale, chaturanga. Cobra. You can also do sphinx, upward dog. This is upward dog. Exhale, downward dog. Inhale, plank. Exhale, step or float your feet forward. Roll it up. Exhale, swan dive. Inhale, half lift, chest, check your posture. Your heart, even though you're facing the floor, your heart is still lifted in your chest, and your shoulders are still back and down. Exhale, hands come down. Step or float your feet back into plank. Exhale, downward dog. Enjoy the downward dog. Inhale, plank. Exhale, chaturanga into upward dog. My chaturangas or chimichangas, as I say, always need work. Exhale, downward dog. Inhale, plank. Exhale, step or float your feet forward. Roll it up, one vertebra at a time. Squeeze that booty. One more time. Exhale, swan dive. Inhale, half lift. Hold that posture. Lift through the heart, drop the shoulders, cinch that waist, get the booty out. Exhale, hands come down. Step or float your feet back into plank. We're going to hold this plank a little bit longer than the first two. Each time,
just because we need to do our planks. Now make sure that your booty is tucked. You're not rattling the spine. The spine is lifted in between the scaps. Waist is cinched. Exhale, downward dog.
Try this. I'm not sure my foot will let me, but I'm going to give it the old
press into the back of your right knee with your elbow and try to draw those hands to center heart space. Okay, so we're not doing this. It's not hands to shoulder, it's hands to heart space. So that keeps the back strong and lifted and the heart strong and lifted, okay?
So, we're gonna do that. Then we're gonna come out of that into crescent, pivot into warrior two, sink down and up, sweep to crescent, and step forward, okay? So let's take that nice and slow. We're gonna slow it way down. So inhale, exhale, left foot steps back, crescent. Make sure that the right knee is directly above the ankle. Your hips are stacked below your shoulders. Hands to your heart space. Take the left elbow to the outside of the right knee. So place it and then push against that, the outside of the right knee, and draw those hands to your heart center. Release back to center into crescent. Pivot feet to warrior two. So this front knee pretty much stays in the same position the whole time. Elbow to knee, side. Sink deep into the hip. Lift, smooth transition into peaceful or reverse warrior. Draw the belly in. Warrior two, go through the checklist, lengthen, lift, cinch, drop, cinch, squeeze, squeeze that left booty, sweep, pivot the back foot back into crescent, and soft step forward, inhale, exhale, right foot steps back, crescent. Back to center, shoulders are stacked above the hips, so that left knee is going to be pretty much stay in the same position. You're going to pivot the back foot, warrior two, strong motion, go through the checklist, so straight line from hand to shoulder, shoulder to hand. Without drawing the shoulder to the ear, I really want you to stretch that side body. Keep your body facing forward, so we're not going to turn the chest at all. Nice strong lift, reverse, or peaceful. Warrior two, go through the checklist, squeeze that right booty, sweep, warrior one, pardon me, pivot, crescent, so now your hips square up, and soft step forward. Very good. So let's come down onto the mats.
We're going to start on our backs. We're going to work the core a little bit. So make sure that you keep all your parts engaged, okay? So, first, we're going to have our knees bent. You're going to find that neutral spine, okay? So you're going to have a space between your spine and the mat. Now, without using the strength of your legs, you're going to contract your lower abdominal muscles, tilting the pelvis up toward the ceiling. You're not going to push the belly out, but now you're imprinted. So there's no space between the spine and the mat. Rule of thumb, if one or both of your feet are off the mat, you're imprinted. So go in and out of that. Inhale and exhale. I call this the lazy man's cat-cow. Use your breath, do not use the strength of your legs. And back to center. So you're going to tilt that pelvis toward the ceiling so you're imprinted. Legs come up. So this is not a leg exercise. So if your legs are straight, that's fine. But if they're bent, if you've got tight hammies, that's fine too, okay? This is a core thing, it's not a leg thing. So, wrap your hands around the thighs, lift the head and shoulders, and rest the head, the weight of your head, into your fingertips. Resist the urge, push that belly out. Exhale, lower that right leg. Hold. Line of sight should be toward your left big toe, not your right. Dorsiflex the right foot, take it out in an abduction, so the toes are still facing the ceiling. Now you're going to feel pressure on that right side. Push through the heel. Now take it back to center and cross it in an adduction. So you're going to cross that leg, cross the midline, which is your sternum, your belly button. Dorsiflex the left foot, take it out to the left. So you're doing an abduction, so I want to make sure that you're leading with the heel. The toe stays pointed toward the ceiling. Take it back to center, adduction. So cross that across the midline. Center, leg comes up, head and shoulders down, knees to chest, rock it out. So let's rock it up. Box position. Extend the right foot, toes curled under, tuck the pelvis. Push, the hands are forward of your shoulders. So when you press into the mat with your hands and you push into the heel of your right foot, that left knee almost feels a little bit weightless. Now you're going to draw that right knee forward again. Try not to drag the foot. Nice low runner's lunge. Lift through the heart. Maybe lift the hands. So sink deep into that hip flexor. Hands come right glute, also in the hamstring and the calf. Really push through the heel, that enhances the stretch a lot. Pushing forward, cross that foot, cross the midline, dorsiflex the right foot to protect your knee. So you can stay here, you can come down onto your elbows, or you can reach all the way up and relax. Try not to lay on that right hip. We really want it to be like it's in a suspension bridge. Bend the left knee, try not to drag it. Place that left foot forward. Sink deep. Lift through the chest. Maybe come up. So again, watch that knee. The knee stays directly above the ankle. Hands come down, pushing off. Dorsiflex the foot so the toes come to face the ceiling. Now push into that left hip, right hip forward, left hip back. And release, cross the foot across the midline, dorsiflex the foot. Again, try not to lay over onto that hip. And you can stay here, you can come to your elbows, or take it all the way down. Relax your jaw. Ever so slowly roll over onto your backs. Your feet come to the outer edge of the mat. Your hands down by your hips, palms up. Find your center, relax the face. So next Thursday, we'll be going to a 70-minute class. We'll start at a quarter till 10. Inhale. Exhale.